Hey everybody, welcome back to Agrarian Skies, and a tree just grew.
Immediately behind you.
Hello, tree. I'm Jubbs, and I'm here with Gam.
I'm Gam!
I had camouflage. That's right, because they made wood armor. It's very exciting.
So, we're here to do some more things to help save the world.
Yes, it's probably beyond saving.
Build it. We can't really save it. We're obviously not going to be repopulating it.
Well, we'll repopulate it with animals so that when we die, life can start anew.
Farmer Bob likes the animals.
Yes. So we've done a tremendous amount off camera. It's been quite a while since we recorded
this. Nothing very much.
Yeah, right, exactly. But as you guys can look around and see, my gosh, so much stuff. Jubbs, what is all this? We've remade the forge. The stone forge has changed. Yes. It's moved locations.
Yes, moved the stone forge. It's moved over here, kind of out of the way. We actually took it down because we had an igneous extruder, but then I realized, how am I going to level up my pickaxes? So I had to build one again, which looks like you have embellished.
Yes, yes, I like the stone slabs.
And then we kind of redid the little courtyard area here to make it more in between without stuff all over it.
Mm-hmm. Gives us some open space, which is very nice.
We added some more levels to the food thing, I can't remember.
Yeah, well, because of all the things we did over there, getting all those seeds and whatnot, we needed to sort of revamp it a little bit. So it's gone quite up a bit.
It's tall.
Mm-hmm. So we got for days. Different foods and cactuses and...
We've solved world hunger.
Yeah, the world hunger is no longer an issue. That is correct. Now, I know we definitely want to get into the food mods, Pam's Harvest Craft and stuff. Hunger Overhaul. I don't even know which. I believe it is Pam's, though.
All the food. It is Pam's, but it's like combined with like a Hunger Overhaul and a bunch of other stuff to make it like worth less.
Uber food madness. So we're going to definitely start that at least a little bit today, just the very beginning of that quest line. This whole building is new, Jubbs. Goodness.
I built a thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh my, very machiny inside.
It's very machiny. So basically, this is where we're gonna do most of our tech stuff. And I made this little area underneath here is kind of an underbelly for all like the grindy stuff that we don't really need. It can all be automated, so we don't have to interact with it. And then our power, which we have expanded out a lot.
Yes, yes.
We made a steam dynamo just for the sake of it.
For the quest.
Chest. It's somewhere. I think it's in a chest somewhere.
No, it's over here. It's just buried a little. Yeah. I even made an aqueous accumulator to fill it with water, just in case we ever wanted to turn it on. It's just off.
Well, have fun.
Yeah, but yeah, we have. Pulverizer is going for all of the things, and they're all going into this great vacuum hopper that Jubbs plopped down, going into this golden chest, sorting all over the place. All of the ores are getting pulled out and going into one of the quest lines that we'll see shortly here. So auto packagers, but I happen to have made lots of them. So they're dropping into all these chests, which are sorted for the individual ore types of, and going into the chest, getting packaged into the types, and then coming out of the chest, just getting pulled right out. And going into, holy smokes, all these smelteries.
so many smelteries.
Yeah, well.
So many.
I just wanted to, the automation needed no more than like 2, maybe 3 max, and I didn't really sort it very well. We have like the shiny and silver one over here, and it doesn't really produce very much because those are not really high on the drop list. But then we have stuff over here. Well, it all gets made very well. And then we have a manual one back here, and then this one's probably going to be for like glass or seared stone or whatever we decide to use it for.
Whatever our little heart desires. What is this? It's white. Oh, silver.
Okay. Mm-hmm. But yeah, there's a ton of stuff. Look at these blocks. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so much stuff. So much stuff. And this is just from being on. So there's a ton that we can play with. Resources are basically under control for most of them.
Yeah, food, resources. Stuff. So we got like the basics that we're going to need under control. Now it's just doing all the questy bits.
Mm-hmm. The questy bits. The infrastructure is sound. Yes. I have one. And many quests available for turn-in. 6 quests with unclaimed rewards right now.
Where's the book at? Have I lost the book?
I don't know. You can make a new one if you want. It should be in tools. I don't know.
Okay. Where's mob drops?
Oh, it's way up there. By the door still. Oh, yeah, Jubbs. You going to show him my trickery?
Oh, God. So it would have been funnier if it would have happened while we were recording, but some troll, which is funny because normally he's not the troll, decided to put glass down here. So it's here like I am going to thinking I'm going to go fight some Monstars, and I walk out here and basically just shit myself because I think I'm going to fall, and then right. I don't.
Yep.
He got an angry text message because I think you were doing something else and I was, I was gonna come grind.
Yeah, it was so funny. But yeah, so yeah, mob spawner is pretty much maxed out as far as we want it. We have a spot over there for something we need to do today, Jubbs. The Nether, it calls for us. And we must visit it. That would be dreadful. I'll probably want to upgrade out of wood armor as it's highly flammable before we do that.
I have made iron.
Yes, it looks magnificent.
Yeah, you're just basically gonna catch on fire.
Yeah.
So
I might want to try Invar armor just for giggles, because it's different.
We gotta make all the armors anyways.
Right. True story. But before we get too crazy, yes.
Any quests that we haven't done that I need to complete?
Probably.
Oh my God! Many. So many.
Yes, many, many.
So many.
Well, there's the zombies one, of course, which we can go ahead and complete. And then on top of zombies, there's, oh gosh, let's start with the powering up one, because that was just to make the steam dynamo, which we did, well, nearly did at the end of last time. Right. So I'll go ahead and get that one.
That's, I think I can do that.
Mm-hmm. And then following that one is the auto packaging one, and it was just to literally make an auto packager, and that just is these guys over here. It takes stuff on the left-hand side from chests and automatically combines it into whatever 2x2 or 3x3, and then outputs that on the right-hand side for the cost of a little power, but very much automated. So it's, what is it like, the auto packagers?
So I like how the powered processing gives you a diamond hammer, which essentially becomes useless when you make a pulverizer.
Yeah.
It has an enchantment on it, so that'll be good.
Well, yeah, it's fortune, actually. So
perfect.
It makes it worthwhile to still have some manual stuff, which is kind of neat. I'm going to take the right bag, because that's how I roll. Cultivating the harvest is one that we are nearly done with, because we did the farming portion, which is just this stuff right here. I just made these things off camera. The harvester, planter, invar sickle, and sludge boiler, just the machines themselves. I made them just so that they were made. The recipes are relatively straightforward, and again, with all of these resources rolling in, that wasn't too difficult. So just went ahead and made them. But we need sludge, and sludge, of course, comes from the harvester. But I believe we built a platform for that if we wanted to start placing things, probably. And that's, I'll just grab that here, actually, as a matter of fact. Boop, 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 boop. Run up this hill. At the top here. Oh, look at this tree. What a beautiful tree. Whatever are we going to do with it?
And we're gonna murder the shit out of it. That's what we're gonna do.
Oh Lord!
I'm violent today. I don't know what it is. I'm just
it's just how it is, I guess.
It's days, something. Mm-hmm, it's being the coffee.
They could be in the coffee. I've had extraordinarily good coffee today. It's because I'm combining lots of different coffees. Whenever I buy a new coffee bag, as I start to get low, I just pour it into the old coffee bag. So it's this hideous conglomeration of all different types of coffees.
Oh, I have the worst coffee. So I have one of those Keurig machines. Other coffee makers are available.
Mm-hmm.
And so it broke recently. Like, or I don't know. Or it's not powering. I don't know. I'm not going to worry about fixing it.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to get my old coffee maker out, right? So, but all I have are these Keurig coffee things.
Mm-hmm.
So I opened them up and tried to pour them into a filter.
Oh, no.
It was the worst tasting coffee.
That actually sounds like an awful idea. Yeah.
Don't do that. It is literally the worst thing you could ever do.
Life lessons, pro tips. So I plant the planter underneath, the harvester to the side. Trouble with the harvester is I see. There's probably a plan. Trouble with the harvester is that while it outputs delightful, delicious lovelies, it also outputs sludge. Yeah, as a byproduct.
Ugh, sludge kills everything.
But we can make this sweet, awesome sludge boiler here to help with that particular problemo. How do I want to probably tempt my life and fate? And, to put it, I believe, like this. Great. And the reason it's out on the scary, scary platform above the hideous void is because the sludge boiler does terrible things with its area of influence, because since it's dealing with such gross product, it makes a poison cloud around it, which in this mod pack is rather deadly, actually. Yeah. But those slow things, and look, look at the sickle jumps.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Kill the sickle.
Oh, that was so much faster.
Yeah, you know, I was thinking when we were, I was grinding some wood. Train of thought completely lost. Oh, I'm down, and to make the leaves go, I was like, I should make a sickle, and I just never did.
Mm-hmm. Well, quest complete. Sickle is made. So what we're going to do is we'll basically set these up, so just make trees like crazy times.
Yes, yeah. I like crazy time trees.
Yeah, but we'll do all that in a second, because there's more quests, more quests.
So many things, so many things.
Like, we must go deeper. It takes an auto brewer, and the brewer actually takes a brewing stand, and the brewing stand requires a blaze rod. But as you recall, Jubbs, you were very, very lucky early on to get the mob drop bag, which came with 16 blaze rods. So I snagged one of those puppies, made a brewing stand, made that into an auto brewer, which is downstairs. We can plug that in at some point. We don't really need potions right now, though they're very helpful. And so we can do all that, and that'll be glorious. So that's the auto brewery bit.
Awesome.
So I'm gonna take the right reward bag.
Yeah. So I took the left as I do.
Mm-hmm.
I have 3 reward bags now.
Good. I also have 3. 2 of them are greater, and 1 is good. But we're not even done. There's 1 left. Never again, Jubbs. And it gives us something that we actually really need: ender pearls.
Yes, because we need to make the jiggers.
Mm-hmm. The
safari nets.
Pokemon balls. Mm-hmm. Because you used the other ones off camera to just to find out what was in them, and our pastures have been dismal failures over here. With they haven't spawned anything, and I don't know if it's the biome or if it's not big enough.
The only thing that spawned are I took a chance with our 2 random mobs things, and I got a cow and a pig.
Which is delightful. See, I am a cow. And the piggy says, no, really, he is a cow. Oh my gosh. We name tagged him because we wanted to despawn. But yeah, what we need to do is make reusable safari nets, pokeballs, so that we can copy these little puppies. Possibly with names and all. And that way we can then breed them or whatever. But right now we've got 1 of each, which is not terribly helpful.
I'm looking to see what I got in my reward bag.
Okay.
Ugh. Amaranth stairs.
Hmm.
Oh, fireworks.
Oh, delightful. We might actually need some of that amaranth stuff.
And a black swallowtail.
Hmm. That can go into the disappointing bag of disappointment with the rest.
Excuse me, bag of disappointment.
Box of disappointment, whichever one it happens to be.
I don't have a thing. I guess this can. I don't have one for. I have potions.
Oh yeah, machines and tech. More magic, but whatever.
Yeah, well, I'll make another one.
We'll call it science.
Yes.
I ain't no magic. That's science. Great. And some hearts into the heart thing.
These can go in here.
Great jobs. We're doing wonderfully.
We are doing wonderfully. So. Yes.
I'm going to hand this reward back. And also drop off these mob drops. Because we only have 3 ender pearls. We need 1 more ender pearl in order to make just 1 reusable thingy.
Which is really all we need.
Yep. But it's going to be interesting because we'll probably have to revisit the mob spawner to make it 3 tall, at least on 1 level for Endermen. But Endermen hate water, Jubbs, and this is a water-dropping one. So we'll actually probably have to make a whole new platform. But I got some ideas for that. We may record. We may not. I mean, we'll address that another time. But
maybe we'll just record it and do like a little speed thing.
Oh, sure. That's a good idea. So I got a potion flask with a useful reward. I hope it's invisibility. Delightful.
It'd be awesome if it was flight.
Yes, because we're going to need that. Oh, I got a couple advanced drawbridges. That's.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
It's definitely not anything I want to play with while I'm floating over the sky.
Yeah, although on the plus side, I did just get some angel blocks, which is helpful for working on nothing. Yes. And lastly, I got an enchanted book with Unbreaking 3.
Oh, hello.
But the book itself is Unbreaking 3, not the enchantment Unbreaking 3. It's just a book with Unbreaking 3.
That's depressing.
Yeah, we got mad trolled this time, Jubbs. Probably because we did it off camera. That's just how it is. Oh, well.
Did you do things off camera?
Yeah, we built stuff.
All right. Oh, do you want to jump? Jump in the Nether?
Yes. Let me spend just a couple seconds whipping together some Invar armor and dropping off these blocks.
Oh, yes. Do you think I'm going to need an axe in the Nether?
Probably not.
Okay, I'm just trying to take as little as possible just in case.
That's a good idea. Ohhmoobooboo, you must stay behind.
Okay.
One of these things.
All right, so if I die, the only thing I'm losing is the sword and the pick. So
I'm going to take my bucket. Yeah, I'll be very disappointed because Orefinder, of course, and the Penetrator. Look at this. Look at this sword.
The Pink Pounder.
Yeah.
Never. Never a serious name.
Never. That would just be so boring. All right. So we need flint and steel, I do believe. Do we have a flint, Jubbs? I know we have a flint. We have
yeah, we've got lots of flint. It should be up there, I'm pretty sure.
I acquire one. And then... Oh. And then a steel. Oop. And then one of them goes one place. Oh my gosh, I did it right first time. Holy smokes. And then, let's see. I'm going to make some Invar armor. Pants. Hat. Boots. Boom, boom, boom. That's a cool trick.
All of the booms.
Yep. And a shirt. Boop, boop, boop. Farewell, wooden armor. Boop, 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 boop. Hello, shininess.
Oh, yay, I've expanded our netherrack farm.
Hooray, glorious. Thank you very much. Yes. We put sand in here from the excess offshoots over there, and it goes through this finally thing is finally working. Just pumping out witch water into the single barrel, which eats it through and then becomes soul sand. And then we'll probably actually change out the sand shifter in there, maybe, I don't know, and then start pumping some soul sand. I don't know, we need a ton of soul sand later too, so that's kind of a good question. But Jubbs, are you ready?
I am prepared.
Okay, good. Let us visit the darkness.
Oh, gosh.
Good idea to jump into water before visiting the Nether.
Just go in there wet.
Soak yourself. Yes.
Yeah, you go kill them. I'll wait. I'll wait over here.
Because, you know, why not? Just fill up my inventory with unnecessary things first.
Fair enough.
Great. It does make me kind of laugh when, look at that, beautiful. When, like, I'll kill a monster, say a zombie, and he'll die, drop some zombie flesh, and another zombie will come down, just pick it right back up, like, zombie bro, no! You know, something like that?
Yeah, that's poor zombie bro. He's like, I'm gonna eat you.
Zombie on zombie action. Oh my gosh, I just lit it up, Jubbs.
I'm a scared.
I'm also a scared. Gird your loins.
Shaking in my boots.
As usual, my friend, thy loins must be girded. Are you prepared? I'm a going in.
I'm a going in. I hit the wrong button.
You let me go in first. Ah, lava.
Age before beauty.
Back in my day, we may do without beautiful people. Oh, Jesus.
There's things. Oh. I hear the ungodly.
Jubbs, we have one very important mission, and that is to acquire immediately netherrack, because it is not findable anywhere except in the Nether, I believe. Oh, I'm a little worried about these other things, though. Can I get this? Effective tool.
I'm getting netherrack right now.
Shoot, I can't get cobalt.
I can't see you. I don't know if you're invisible or not.
I'm just behind you. Ooh, that was kind of a nice nether. Look at these.
You're invisible.
That's okay. I'm right near the thingy. Can I get ardite? Ooh, I can get ardite.
That's I also can do that.
Can you get the cobalt? I cannot get cobalt.
I should be able to get cobalt. Let me...
Go ahead and grab cobalt if you can.
Wait, hang on. Mining level's ardite.
Curses. Well, I just have to come back with ardite stuff. Pick them up, because there's a cobalt right there, and then we'll have manilium. That'll be quite pleasant.
Yes.
Although we'll only be able to make, like, one manilium thingy. Well, this is nice. There's, like, nothing here. I mean, I shouldn't say that, because that'll spawn all the things, but, you know.
Okay, I have a stack of things. I don't even know where you're at, and that's really confusing me.
I'm still by the thingy.
Okay, I've explored a bit. Ah, imps.
Ooh, imps.
Leather would be very handy.
Oh, I can kill them to make the... Hey, you're climbing in the lava. That's a problem.
Oh, Lord. What is this? Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. There's a named mob. I can't see. I'm blind and poisoned. I don't know if I killed him or not, but I'm running. I'm very injured, Jubbs. I may die.
Run! Don't die.
Well, I'm poisoned, so hopefully.
Oh, well, go back to the portal. Die. Go back to the portal.
I've done this.
Oh, I see a. Oh God.
Might want to try.
Oh, there's a thing.
Might want to try to get out of there. I'm quite dying-y.
There's the thing.
Mm-hmm. Holy smokes.
He's a special.
Yeah. So that's why it's the super monster mod.
Oh God! How do I get back to the portal? What did we come here for? Why did we come here?
We came here for Netherrack. We achieved it. Flee!
I'm trying to flee in a roundabout way.
Very well, as long as you don't die horribly.
I jumped in the lava.
Well. Did you?
It's unfortunate.
That is very unfortunate, especially if you perish.
Oh God! Oh God!
Did you actually jump into lava?
I forgot about the back jump thing of this.
Oh, the rapiers.
I'm running. I am going to burn to death.
Oh no. How horrifically unfortunate.
Oh God, I went out. I have two hearts. I'm standing still. I'm gonna wait till I This is the worst thing ever. Why did we come here?
Jubbs, do you need the waypoint for the way back or something?
No, I think I can find it. I just need to avoid that super silverfish.
Alright, how's your health?
It's halfway.
Alright, how's your hunger?
It's full.
Good. That much at least is good.
Yeah, I'm waiting for it in my health to get up there. Oh my God, the world. The world.
All right, as soon as I'm fully healthed, well, I'm going to drop off some of this stuff. And then as soon as I'm fully healthed, I'm going to come back in and save you by just being there. And hopefully not stab you a bunch. Drop off this stuff in the nearest convenient chest.
Okay, I'm coming up.
It's there.
Did you go back through?
Yes, I did. So if you can come back through, that
would probably be. I'm coming. I'm running.
Good.
Oh, there's a spider. Oh God.
Well, spiders are not too bad, but probably still not ideal.
Oh, that was stressful.
Mm-hmm. Did you success? Oh, I see you. Glorious day, Jubbs. Neither of us died horribly, although I...
Look at all this. Look at it. Look at it.
Throws it off the side.
Look at it.